Hello, this is Shane from Vicamp Capital. Today I'm going to run through a very basic method to value stocks and value plain equity. So I'm going to run through the multi-stage dividend discount model. Now, there are a lot of different variations of the dividend discount model, and certainly they're here to be improved and they're here to really be played around with, but at least this is one example. So obviously this doesn't work with stocks that don't pay dividends, so the stock that you want to be selecting is obviously going to be one that's giving you a cash flow. So in this case I've got a fictional stock where I have three estimated dividends over the next 3 years. Here are three values. I have the beta of the stock, the expected return of the S&P over that time period, and the treasury bill rate at the moment. Notice that I also have the growth rate of future dividends at 6%, and the first bit of calculation comes with K, which is the discount rate. So here all I've done is I've used CAPM to get a figure for the discount rate. So in other words, I've just done D16 treasury bill plus beta times by the market premium, and market premium is just the S&P minus the treasury bill. So moving on to the cash flows, year one, what I've done is I've taken D11 and just divided that by 1 plus the discount rate, because what we're doing here, we're trying to get the net present value of this investment. And year two, I've done exactly the same thing, except I've put that to the power of 2 at the end, because it's 2 years, you have 1 plus the discount rate to the power of 2. Now here, this P3 actually stands for cash flows expected after, or valuing the cash flows after year 3. So what I've done here is I've taken the year 3 times that by 1 plus the growth rate, because that's going to be year 4, and I've divided that by D18 minus D17. So in other words, that is the discount rate minus the growth rate. So again, that's year 4 divided by D18 minus D17. And it's very similar to valuing. I'm not sure if you've ever valued a perpetuity, but it's the same way that you would value even preferred stock as well. You just divide the coupon payments, because you think that it's going to be going on, you know, for forever, perpetuity goes on forever, and the same as is applied to preferred stock, and you just divide it by these two figures. So the end value of the stock, all one does is one adds up the three discounted cash flows, except for the final one, of course, which is a little bit modified. But if we can see here, we have D20, which is year 1, plus D21, which is the year 2 discounted cash flow, and then we add 4.5 to the final figure here. We add 4.5 plus this P3 value that we have here and discount both of those values together. And of course, since that's 3 years in the future, we do 1 plus discount rate to the power of 3, and we get a value of 102.08, and that should be the real minimum price that it should be trading at, because if your calculations are correct and you think those dividends are right, then that's really the fair value of the stock. And of course, there are many exceptions to this. But in short, you know, a lot of people use this and can find it, you know, I'm not sure if it would be accurate, but certainly helpful and a guideline in, you know, one of those extra parameters that one uses when looking at investment opportunities or fair value of stock, clearly. So that's it. Thank you very much. Feel free to, you can download the spreadsheet in the description. As I said, it's always good to play around with these things yourself, develop the model, and you know, I hope it does certainly come off some help to you. Thank you very much for watching.